Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Legend of Dragoon. Rather, the Legend of Dragoon. In the last episode, we finally obtained the Red Eye Dragoon Spirit and the Black Dragoon Spirit. I was about to say purple, but anyways. So, we defeated Kongol. We got Dark Dragoon Spirit. We have Rose in the party now, which I'm going to switch out Shanna for Rose, because even though Shanna is useful for some battles, Rose is definitely the better party member to have for the majority of the game. Okay, so now that we have the Dragoon Spirit, I can finally explain a few things. Alright, you see it's level 4, add 1. Add 1 means there's only one button press that we have to do. Volcano has 3, and we garner 35 SP for every time we fully complete Double Slash. Now, we're 5 away from getting to level 5, which will yield more SP, so on and so forth. So the further you level up the additions, the more SP and damage you garner. And same thing with Harpoon, 42 SP, 35 SP, 30 SP damage, and then Rose has Whip Smack, which is my, like her voice lines whenever it comes to her additions are pretty great. But anyways, so now we're on our way to the Marshlands to help them out at the Stronghold. So let's go to the Marshlands! But, best thing to do whenever you have the Dragoon Spirit ready, use it as much as possible. Use it as much as possible so that you're able to level it up more. Because if I'm correct, the more you use it, the more likely you are to level it up, rather than just passively using it here and there. So yeah, use it every chance you get. You don't have to use the magical attacks. We'll link it to that as well whenever we actually have our Dragoon Bar leveled up. We'll get the Dragoon Bar filled up. But right now we're still just accruing that juicy SP. So we're gonna go down here. It's time to go to the Marshlands. How's everybody doing today? I'm doing fairly well. I had another wonderful day at work. Now I'm just chilling here, recording, and oh yeah, here we go. Okay, we're recording a video and stuff and things, and go, Dart. Jesus. So there's nothing over there. Come on. Yeah, we're gonna go this way. Oh. But we're actually making a lot of progress now. I'm super happy about that. We're still gonna encounter those sections where talking is definitely going to be prominent, but that's okay. Sometimes it's good to have a break from the action. And now we're finding mushrooms. I love the sound effects. Pretty cute.
Whip smack!
Alright. Okay, so Rose is definitely, English today. Rose definitely gets more turns than anybody else because her speed is, I believe, the highest, second to Maru, if I remember this correctly. I think the further that the more she's leveled up, the faster her turns will come to her. That's why she's one of the more valued party members to have. I mean, you can have whoever you want in your party. Kind of like mine's usually, a little bit later on we obtain a man named Hachelle and Maru. I prefer using them because Hachelle is that boy and Maru has a lot of good stuff underneath her sleeve. Wait, what the hell is the other way? You know, I think I do this every single time I come into the Marshlands. I'm like, oh, I want to go that way. No, let's go the other way. No, we're going to go back to make sure I'm not missing anything. Yeah, see, we can go forward. Okay, we're going to read the sign. Oh, man. Double slash.
Yes. Double slash.
God, Rose is so much damage. That's another thing about Rose. She has a high damage output as well. And the mushroom went away. Cool. I had to worry about that, but that's a loss of experience. But that's okay. No worries. But to go to show why it's important to use your Dragon Spear as much as possible, I think with the end of Disc 1, left its Volcano Balloon. Okay, we do have to go straight. So yeah. But the thing about the end of Discord, I had Darth's Dragoon Spirit up to level 3 or level 4, if I'm remembering this correctly. Oh. Oh. Alright, so left is Volcano Balloon, where I think we have to go next, but right now we have to go to the 7th fort, and here we are, ready to lend our hand in aiding these knights. Oh my god! Oh, come on now. Nah, son, I'm gonna fight you. I got a nice cold glass of Cherry Coke Zero. It's gonna keep me parched. Wait, keep me parched? Wait, no. Parched is the opposite of what I wanna be. God bless if I can actually talk. See, that's the number one thing. Whenever I'm recording, I tend to fumble over my words a lot, and I apologize ahead of time. But I'm hydrated. This Cherry Coke Zero is gonna keep me hydrated and not fart. That'd be like drinking sand and dried polenta in a mixture of like wet cement. That's something I can really compare it to. Sounds pretty disgusting, which it probably is, TH. I don't know, never done that. I mean, if you wanna drink that combination, let me know how that goes. I wouldn't recommend it. God, Rose. Rose is definitely putting in work. Spear Frost. And remember, Lavix has a low magic defense, so he's going to get hit hard. Bedard's getting up there in the damage output. So is Lavix. As long as we keep nailing these additions properly, yeah, we're going to get those levels up. Levels. Really, relatively. Oh, God, I'm gonna get situated. There we go. Alright. So we finished off that battle, and we're gonna keep moving forward. Alright, so that knight got his shit kicked in.
You bastard!
Get out of my way, son. FWM, fuck with me. Fuck with me, boy. Okay. In this battle, we're actually going to activate our Dragoon Spirit. So we can see that awesome transformation. You know, I never. In the last decade that I've been playing this game, I never get tired of seeing that transformation sequence. Never. There's an option to turn off the transformation sequence where you just hit Dragoon and then boom, you're done. But who would do that? Alright, so this is our D attack. It's like an addition, but we have to time that dial. You have to time it. There's like such a tight-knit time frame for that. And it's hard to land sometimes if you don't know what you're doing, which it's been a while since I've actually and we use the D attack. But let's try to redeem ourselves with Rose if it's Rose's turn. Alright, now we're gonna let Rose transform. Oh my god. Hers is just beautiful, man. I don't care what anybody says. Alright, let's try this again. Let's try this D attack one more time. Let's focus. There we go. Now we got a perfect yeet. Now watch this. And if you complete it, look at all that damage you did once you get that perfect. And you spend 5 times on that 5th time, you have to nail it. You have to nail each rotation perfectly. Otherwise, it's just... Well, you saw what happened if I tried using. And obviously, I mean, it just goes to show that timing is important. Also, I mean, as the name implies, everybody's gonna get a Dragoon Spirit, so whenever we get Lavitz's Dragoon Spirit, oh, just wait. Just wait. So you get a peek at the Dragoon sequence as well as the attack. You know, as much as I really want to use SP, I'll show you the magical attacks that each of the Dragoons have at level 1. Alright, we're gonna go up here, go to the left. Well, he's gonna come down to us, so I mean... I won't let you leave alive, is that so? Fight me! How about thee? Honestly, I love battles in this game. Like, I don't know what it is, it's just... Some people tend to skip over battles just so they can progress. And I know I may have said that it's better to make a lot of progress rather than diddle. There we go with the stutter. Diddle that. I can't even pronounce it. What the hell? Shilly shally dilly dally. Faltering. There. If we're going to be professional, it's no point in faltering. Is what a lot of people will say. For those of you who have watched Advent Children, you'll get the whole dilly dally shilly shally thing. So anyways, you got a first-hand look at my stutter and how I hate it so much. And why does it not melt down yet? Oh, because he's still in the yellow. Cool. I'm gonna play a phantom off. Ugh, whip smack. She can whip smack me any day. Alright, so we defeated him, and I think we can't get that chest yet until we kill all the guards. Yep. It's forced us to head that way. That's cool, we can get it on the way out. Alright, we're gonna have to make Lavitz guard just so we can get some HP back up. I'm sorry, what kind of painful cry was that, Lavitz? Alright, we're gonna go ahead and transform again, because again, it's always important to transform any chance that you get, just to make sure that we're getting those levels. Sorry for the smacking of the Truant. Get some ice, bruh. Get some crushed ice beside me. There we go, get another perfect. Yeet. And another insta-kill. Bop. There we go. Now we're going to de-transform. Let's go back into our human state.
It's okay. It's no problem with that.
And I'm gonna show you guys the magical attacks whenever, I don't know, boss battle? Or at least against harder enemies, not the Sandor Knights. But now I'm gonna focus on those D attacks, son! Right, let's see if we can get darts. There we go! Are you kidding me? That didn't insta-kill him? So that goes to show that Rose is definitely superior in the party right now. Oh yeah, Rose's magic defense is pretty elite. Yeah. Eventually we'll move on from Double Slash to Volcano, I promise. I promise. I got one more battle. Sorry if I'm not as interactive and talking today. My throat is giving me a lot of trouble. So if I go quiet for a good period of the video, I apologize in advance. Clear my throat as much as possible just so it doesn't interfere with the audio. Get that kill on. Oh, sorry about that, guys. And is it that magical item? Nope, that was another one. I think our damage increased.
Yes.
But the looks of it, I think we did finally hit level 5 on double slash. I don't think we're gonna get any more SP besides that. But we can peek at it after we get a chance to. Is that it? Oh no, I forgot there's the commander. Bet, son. Okay, now we're gonna get some D magic popping off. That's so cute, because I looked to my left and I see my daughter in the kitchen just staring at me. She's like, blip, 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 blip. Such a cutie. Let's see. Don't want to use it. We're gonna take care of that soldier. We're gonna get rid of them if we're fighting the commander. Or we can just take out the commander.
Yes! Double slash!
Oh, come on, Lavitz! Oh, damage. That's not bad. Why are they picking on Lavitz? Like, every single attack's like, yeah, we know we're gonna centralize the Lavitz in our line of fire. Do we? No. Why is it always Lavitz? What the hell did he do? Alright, just this. Would it one time? Hopefully. Fuck, I can't talk! I can't bloody say the right words! If the battle, like, drags on, I'm gonna use the D attack more often. I'm gonna use the D magic just this once in this battle. I'm trying to say, I think we can only use it. Oh, we can use it twice, but we only have one bar of mana. Unless the enemy has a low magic resistance, it's not going to do a whole lot. That's why D attack is the better option. But Rose is level 1 D magic, on the other hand. Ugh. But the good thing about today is I have a few friends coming over a little bit of TV company. I might be recording a little bit of Heroes of the Storm. I'm sure yet. But okay, Astral Drain. We're going to use Astral Drain on the commander. You see, every time she uses Astral Drain, it looks like she is just projecting that beam of light out of her butt. It's always funny to me. It always has been funny to me. 16 health, I mean.
That's not bad.
Could have been better. And it will be better on later enemies, but definitely the commander or the grunge. So we're gonna go ahead and use one of our healing greens. Everybody's healed up, we're topped off, now it's time to do the battle.
Whip smack.
Oh, paralysis. Dope. And the paralysis is broken, I think. Yep. My baby wanted to say hi. She's getting grumpy because I'm recording and not paying attention to her. But I'm like, sweetheart, let daddy record. And the commander's down. Dope. Try again, destroy this guy, and then we're good to go. And this should finish him off. And it does.
Yes. Double slash.
We got an attack ball. Neat. Okay, now we can go back and get that treasure chest. Oh, Sun Rhapsody. That refills our D magic gauge. Everybody survive? I wonder. Oh. That's never a good sound. Oh, this is depressing. Oh. Oh no. Oh boy. I'm not gonna go talk to him yet. I'm gonna get the treasure chest first. Did Lyman's get a new weapon? I think he did. Yes, sir. Lyman's putting in that work now. The sugar additions really quick. Oh, it's already done? Okay, cool. So, Double Slash is topped out at 88, so we're gonna move on to Volcano. Harpoon is still at 56 out of 60. Already at 15 out of 20 for Whip Smack. Not bad. Not bad at all. Definitely getting more than I have in my main file. Guess it's time to head towards the Volcano of Alude now. God. Is he like the death scene where people are like dying in this game, or just so heartbreaking? You're like, oh no, it's just a video game character. I'm like, yes, but I relate. Not that I relate to him. It's like I feel like I'm being an empath is so. It's a double-edged sword. It's like, okay, cool. But it's like, your feeling for a video game character. I'm like, yeah, no. But we have feelings too. Pre-programmed feelings, but feelings. No, I'm pretty sure the other volcano was. But you will get to see it. The next time Dart's turn comes around. Alright, let's focus. Fuck. I messed that up. Sometimes it's really hard to land it, especially if I get in a way to master it with proper timing, but sometimes I'm just like, okay. I do like the thing called the head nod. I nod after every rotation, and I time it so that I know I want to hit the dial just right. Rose? Let's find out. I did not get the fifth one. I did get four, though. Oh, 62. Maybe my friend was right. Maybe Rose should just stay in the party. I remember we were talking about the our usual lineup in our parties for Legend Dragon, he always kept Rose. And I was like, ah, I never really used Rose that much. Unless, like, it forced me to. But now I'm looking at her in a different light. God. So that was Volcano, and that circle that you saw was a, anyways, he had it circle, otherwise you get knocked back and damage dealt to you instead. Bruh, these mushrooms just don't want to take the L. Just die already, son. Again with the mushrooms! Oh, they must have a high evasion rate. Oh, yeah. Is this a magical item, or is it just like... Oh, yeah, yeah. Alright. It hurts my soul every time I see that. But in other news, this is pretty funny. So in my hometown, there was this juvenile officer. And my name is, but you know, he was always that up-and-coming guy in that field, I guess in law enforcement. And, well, you know, he had outstanding character, and you would think that he would do no wrong. Well, obviously, in this day and age, that is proven false time and time again. Well, come to find out, he was in prison for receiving stolen property. And I couldn't help but to see the irony in that, because he would continuously, like, siege my brother over and over about how he should be stealing, how he should be doing this and doing that. So the irony there... It gave me a good giggle. So what stories do you have about law enforcement, that whether it be comedic or just, I don't know, just being a passerby? I know something like that, nothing like excessively harsh, because I know, like, talking about law enforcement and cops and everything, it's a touchy subject, but... And that's one thing right there, you know, a cop getting in prison for doing the same thing that they tell criminals not to do. Kind of like a DARE officer from the same town that I used to go to was caught, like, dealing drugs. I'm like, what the hell? You're supposed to be teaching kids not to do drugs, but you're sitting back there smoking Baphomet's broccoli. Yes, it's not devil's lettuce anymore. A friend of mine shared a picture, and it was, instead of devil's lettuce, they're saying, yeah, don't smoke Baphomet's broccoli, and it made me giggle. I liked it. Alright, we got the boat. I think there's a chest. Yes, the chest is right there. Spirit potion. We're gonna take a boat ride for a hot minute. Okay, so moving to the right takes us back to shore. Okay. Now we'll move down. Then we're gonna get off right here so that we get that chest and get to another battle. That's inevitable. Crocodilies. Ouch. Well, it is a crocodile, huh? Yeah, it looks like they have a high physical defense. That's okay. No big deal. No big deal. See, the bad thing is, even though they probably have a high physical defense, they have a small health pool. Volcano!
Yes!
God, I love the voice acting in this. It's just so perfect. Volcano! It fits each character perfectly. And whenever we get whenever our party gets to expand and hear everybody else's voice lines. Oh, I got Burning Rush. Oh, it's definitely one of my favorite additions. Along with one we get later on in the game called Madness Hero. That one is probably. I think that one has the most button presses, if I remember correctly. Or I think it's the last one, Dynamic something. I think it's Dynamic Hero. Yeah, I think it's Dynamic Hero. Let's get off right here. And then we move to the left. Oh my god. You know what? Sure. Let's use a Sun Rhapsody just to clear out some room for this next item. A Body Purifier. Probably my wife's decision, but.
Whatever.
Oh, yeah. Another bit of news. Another bit of news. I'll be in Nashville this Saturday, so no videos will be put out on on Saturday. One will be coming out tomorrow still, but Saturday and Sunday are going to be my off days. So I'm going to try my best not to record, but I can't promise anything. I know I should probably not upload a video like consecutively because, you know, sometimes that gets old. But how do you feel about that? How do you feel about a video being uploaded daily as opposed to, Monday through Friday? By taking a break on Saturday and Sunday, or would you rather have one daily? Well, let's hear from you guys about that.
Yes. Gus. Volcano.
A crocodile puking up skulls. What's new? Get to Volcano Balloon. That is about to level up. That's
awesome. That's awesome.
Oh, you gotta go there and get the chest. Oh my god. Let's see. Can we discard something? I have the healing potion. Huh. Care about those. Not really so much the body purifiers, because I mean, yeah, they're useful, but, oh, Magic Stone of Signet. I forgot what that does. And I may see my, oh yeah, I know what that item does. No, I completely forgot. I should open up the menu and taking a look at it. Like, you know what, YOLO, let's just keep going. Just around the riverbend. Or was it? I don't remember Disney lyrics all that much, unless it's like Moana. If I butchered that song, I'm sorry, and you're more than welcome to castrate me. Alright, now we can progress up. You gonna hurt my boy? Get on my level! That was a powerful yawn. God bless. Yeah, we're gonna try to see. I said this already, but I was very tired of it. Very tired of those transformations at all. I should have went for the merman. Bless. There we go. Got that perfect rocking and rolling. Hoo! 98 damage this early on in the game is stupendous. Oh, hallelujah! Hallelujah! Sorry about that. So thank you for the day when I was streaming Overwatch, like, religiously. I believe it was from November all the way up to January. I would do this thing where I would take it, like, I would honestly have, like, some kind of random drink, but every time I would sip it, I would go, ah, sponsored by Pepsi. No, it was, oh god, what was it? I can't remember what it was. I think it was like I died or got killed. Something I was like, and that was sponsored by Pepsi, or one of the streams. I don't know. Anyways, and friends like, you should email Pepsi to get a sponsorship. I'm like, no, I'm not gonna get a sponsorship, especially with how little people are subscribed to my channel. Now, if I had like 100,000 subscribers, that'd be different. But I don't. Which I'll be creating another YouTube channel. Got to re. You're paying all my subscribers, which is fine. It's okay. And that was the only time we got a mind purifier. I think that's one. I didn't get a chance to see it. That's okay. That's okay.
Yeek!
What's wrong? That's it? Just stuck in the mud? Get out of here! She twisted her ankle. What the hell? Come on now. That was so cute. Aww. You literally walked maybe a few feet. No. No, twist your ankle. I'm gonna give you a piggyback for like 5 steps. Okay, we're finally out of the marshlands. I think we're gonna end it here because the Volcano of Elude definitely has a, it's a lot longer, I'll tell you that much. It's twice as long as the Hoax and the Marshlands combined. So we're going to hit save and end the episode here. Oh, man. I had a lot of fun there. Definitely saddening, you know, the night's falling and that touching moment between Dart and Shannon. But anyways, hopefully you enjoyed this episode. Remember to like the video, like the page, share the video, share the page, do anything and everything to get my name out there. I would greatly appreciate it. And as always, guys, thank you for tuning in. Splash on, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.